it, love it.
Look, it's the limousine fault.
Yeah.
It's fault. Right, John, thank you. Okay, so I could take...
Thank you.
the streaming man.
Yes.
Wonderful. Okay. So I'm not trying to get the space for you so that you can start streaming. Okay.
I'm doing it already. Wonderful. Thanks.
Thank you. this time.
Welcome and please be seated. I welcome you all to Basildon United Reformed Church this morning. Welcome into the presence of God. As we draw close to God, God draws close to us. We are here today to pay tribute to Akua, to remember her before God and to give thanks for her life. Times like these are always times of such sadness and sorrow when a loved one departs from us. And today for you is no exception. But I pray that amidst the sorrow and the loss that you feel, you, her family and friends here, you will be able also to celebrate the life that she lived. As you pray and hear words from Scripture, may you find in them both comfort and hope and celebration in the sure knowledge of the resurrection and that of eternal life. Jesus gives us these words: "Don't let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God and trust also in me. There is more than enough room in my Father's home. If this were not so, would I have not told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? When everything is ready, I will come and get you so that you will always be with me where I am. And you know the way to where I am going." Hymns and songs this morning have been especially chosen by the family, including this first one that we sing together, "Abide With Me."
Thank you.
seated and come into prayer. We pray, God, our Creator, you made all the rhythms and patterns of creation, and just as you give us birth, so you are there when death comes. You have made us mortal beings of frail flesh and gentle spirit, and you give us a span of life, a time to be born and a time to die. Today we see the value of life and glad that it may be lived within the knowledge of your eternity. Loving God, you comfort those who mourn. We come before you, believing you share our love for Akua and know our sense of loss at her death. Assure us of your love and support. Support us with your strength today and in the days to come. God of all creation, Jesus, the risen one, Holy Spirit, bringing hope and new love. God, the Holy Trinity, we pray to you and claim your comforting love this day and always. Amen.
Amen.
We pray the Lord's Prayer together, words that Jesus taught us as we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. My privilege now to hand over to Pastor Chris, who I know is well known and loved amongst you all.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Well, we just bless the name of the Lord for everything that God has done. Because in all, the Bible says, in all things we also give thanks to the Lord. He owns our life. May God bless you. The next on the program is biography reading. I will call on our sister. God bless you.
Biography of the late Akua Abraham. Good people pass away. The godly often die before their time. But no one seems to care or wonder why. No one seems to understand that it is protecting them from evil to come. Those who follow a godly path will rest in peace when they die. This is from Isaiah 57, verses 1 to 2. Akua BUABENG Abraham was born in London, Withington Hospital in Archway. She was born on the 3rd of January 1973 to lawyer A.G. BUABENG and Reverend Beatrice BUABENG Yamua. Her father worked with many organizations in Akua's youth: Black Star Line, WAEC, Ghana Airways, and many more. Her mother was a teacher, a scientific officer at the Atomic Energy Commission, a nurse, and eventually a retired minister of the United Reformed Church and Presbyterian Church of Ghana. Akua was the eldest and became a second mother to her two siblings, Baba and Inyama BUABENG. Akua started nursery in London, then moved to Ghana, to Tiny Tots Nursery School of the late Mrs. Achiman, whom they loved. Akua continued her education at Northridge Church Lyceum Church School, I beg your pardon, in Accra. She then attended Infantiman Secondary School and proceeded to complete a secondary education in a private school in London. Akua obtained her degree from South Bank University and after attained her PGCE, and she also attended King's College, where she obtained a degree in mental health nursing and became a qualified mental health nurse. It seemed Akua almost followed her mother's footsteps. However, Akua was an exceptionally gifted child. She could read newspapers from the age of 3. She read the Times newspapers at a young age, which was her father's favorite newspaper. And it was a sight to see a child in a plane reading huge Times newspaper. Akua was a fun-loving person till the end. Akua's whole life was to serve and work hard. She loved caring for people. Akua was a kind, sympathetic, loyal, generous, and very serious person. She loved to make everyone around her happy. We hope we could have given her half of the love she showered on all of us. Akua was selfless concerning her family, her parents, and even her friends. We are all wondering what will become, what happened to us without Akua. But God, the caring one, will take over. Akua left behind a husband, Mr. Fifi Abraham, 5 children, Grace, Chioma, James, Elion, and Elliot. Akua loved worshiping God and also loved dancing. May the Lord whom she loved keep her happy and peaceful and still dancing. Akua was a blessing to all of us. And let her soul continue to glorify our God in heaven. As a mother, I can only say to my daughter that I will never stop loving her. But now I can only say to my father that it seems he loves her best. Akua, be happy and rest in peace till we meet again.
Can I call upon Auntie Sewa? Auntie Sewa, Semagan, for the tribute.
Tribute by Class of 1919, Fatuan Old Girls Association. What peaceful hours I once enjoyed. How sweet the memories tell. But they have left an aching void the world can never fill. Methodist Hymn 461, the third verse. How time flies. Where do we begin to write this? 37 years ago, we met at Homos of Infantiman Girls Secondary School. Many of us were preteens who had never left home. We all had insecurities, but we had all been successful in the common entrance exams, and we're proud to begin the next phase of our lives in boarding school. Akua BUABENG, as we fondly called her, was one of us. She was assigned to Chinwe House in Form 1S. She had a clique from primary school in Tesano, Accra. However, we found her to be very affable and generous. She didn't talk too much, but she could diffuse tension simply by flashing her pearly white teeth. We survived Form 1 and soldiered on. Before we could write at all levels, Akua left us for the UK, and many of us completely lost touch with her. Some years ago, however, we were introduced to the magical world of social media, and we were able to connect via Facebook and others. When our year group WhatsApp platform was created, Akua was one of the most active participants. She would drop lines of encouragement on birthdays and other events. Akua was an avid reader. When one of our mates started posting short stories, she would always ask for the next episode, stating she needed the stories for her long train rides to work. Akua had the spirit of giving and didn't mind supporting her friends financially. When our year group was tasked with co-hosting our school speech day, she sent some money and charged us to keep her contributions anonymous. That was our Akua. We learned what a warrior she was after her passing. Most of us never knew she was sick, as she maintained active participation on our WhatsApp platform till her dying day. Akua, obra nyawara abo. Obra pasuja ura kwan ampa. Your work on earth is done. Heavenly Father, in your gracious keeping, we leave our friend and sister sleeping. Amen. God saw you getting tired, and a cure was not to be. So he put his arms around you and whispered, "Come with me." With tearful eyes, we watched you suffer and saw you fade away. Although we loved you dearly, we could not make you stay. A golden heart stopped beating, hard-working hands at rest. God broke our hearts to prove he only takes the best. It's lonesome here without you. We miss you more each day. Life doesn't seem the same since you've gone away. When days are sad and lonely and everything goes wrong, we seem to hear you whisper, "Cheer up and carry on." Each time we see your picture, you seem to smile and say, "Don't cry, I'm in God's keeping. We'll meet again someday." You never said, "I'm leaving." You never said goodbye. You were gone before we knew it, and only God knew why. A million times we needed you, a million times we cried. If love alone could have saved you, you never would have died. In life, we loved you dearly. In death, we love you still. In our hearts, we hold a place that no one could even fill. It broke our hearts to lose you, but you didn't go alone, for part of us went with you. The day God took you home, Rhoda Braswell. Amen.
Hallelujah. Right, I will call on Sister Shilma to give a brief tribute as well.
Thank you, Pastor Prince. So this is a tribute for myself, Shilma, the second child. Romans chapter 8, verse 38 to 39, and I paraphrase, "Neither life or death can separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. My mom was a woman of faith who loved the Lord and served, always putting others above herself. She has now returned to her true home, and I'm grateful and privileged to have been my mother's daughter. I remember when she would work overnight and come home early in the morning. I would normally be so happy to see her back from work or when I get home from work in the evening. I was always so happy to come and meet her at home. Time will not permit me to share all the loving memories and happy memories of my mom. She was a rock of our family, bringing us all together and taking care of us in the best way she could. Dearest mother, I love you and I know I'll meet you again once my destiny has been fulfilled."
Thank you. May God comfort the family in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I will call upon Grace as well to give a brief tribute.
Okay. I don't even know what to say. I think what I want to say, Mummy, is thank you. Mummy Adawase. Mummy gave herself for everyone continuously, and I don't think that she took care of herself enough. And I don't think we have the words to say thank you. Mummy would tell me stories of how when she was in Nigeria and how hard it was, and how the only thing that kept her alive was her kids. And Kole, I can't go because I need to take care of these kids. And I remember in April when I heard my mom crying, I heard her crying and I was concerned. I ran and I went to the bathroom and I was like, Mommy, why are you crying? And she was like, hey, the doctor said I have some disease. And I said, hey, Mommy, we thought it was something. It was just your throat. And she said, no. They said it's motor neuron disease. They said, Mommy, don't worry. And even though she was sick, she couldn't speak well. She couldn't eat well. Her only thing was, hey, so what I do about the kids? And so at every point in Mommy's life, her thing was her children. How will I work? How will I go to work? How will I provide? How will I pay the bills? And I wish that we could have taken care of her more. I really wish that we could. Mommy, we had so much planned for your 50th. Mommy, our graduation, my graduation's coming. My wedding is coming. And Leon's gonna become a lawyer. And Leon's gonna become a football player. He's gonna be great. Choma's gonna preach. James is gonna be amazing and he won't be able to see it. But Mommy, it's okay. Cause you've laid a foundation and a path for us. So we're grateful. Mommy, why are you here? Thank you, Mommy. We want to say thank you. We don't know how to thank you enough. Thank you for fighting. Thank you for staying as long as you did. Mommy, just thank you. Thank you. That's all. Thank you.
Amen.
Amen. May God protect and continue to console the family in Jesus' name. Because there is nothing that can replace this vacuum in their life. But I know that our good Lord will fill the gap in Jesus' name. So I will call upon the husband to come and say something. If you can. It's all right. Oh, for the husband, okay.
I am not the husband. I'm reading the tribute from the husband, starring Fifi Debrown. To the love of my life. Her beauty caught my eye, and I spoke the word. What word was it, Akua? I love you. And she agreed. She accepted my proposal, and the date was set on the 2nd of February 2003. We exchange rings, laugh, and enjoy ourselves. But never did we expect this day. This is a dream, and it's still a dream. I never thought this day would ever come. Not to my lovely wife. This is a huge blow to my life. My wife, Akua, was a bright, beautiful, lovely, and courageous woman. And her life for family and friends will always be remembered. My dearest Akua, you made all our lives so much better. Your impact was incredible. Akua was my best friend, an amazing wife, and mother who dedicated her life to her family and also to her friends and colleagues. My wife was charismatic, adorable, and romantic. Indeed, Akua was romantic. As for that one, I'll give it to her. She was a romantic person in our marriage. She taught our children to know and serve God with Christian values. She taught them how to be brave and keep pushing when things are tough. In our marriage, we argued as we all do, fought, cried, kissed, hugged each other. She was my darling, and I was her sweetheart. That's what the Akua called Fifi, sweetheart. I love you so much, darling. We will be together again. Yours from the very first time I saw you, and forever, your sweetheart. Rest in peace, my dear. Till we meet again. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you. Well, to round everything up, I will like to call upon Akua's father. She still has father, a loving father, to come forward and then give some word of encouragement and tribute to his daughter. You're welcome, sir. Right. On this rather inauspicious occasion, I'll be extremely brief and I'll only make a statement. I'm not going to read a tribute. I will start by quoting from Felix Mendelssohn's Elijah, "Rest in the Lord, Akua." And as Cheryl, the ferryman, in Virgil's Aeneid, Book 5, ferries you across the river Styx to the Elysian plains, I hope the angels will sing for you Verdi's Requiem. Say hi to my dear mother you never met when you meet her on the Elysian plains. It's been hard to learn that you've passed away. But we give glory to God for your short life, and I believe that you continue to rest in the Lord. Thank you.
Thank you. Sorry. May the Lord be with the family in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Right, I'm going to call on Pastor John to lead us through our next him through all the changing sense of life. God bless you, sir.
Praise the Lord.
Bless my brother. Praise God.
Thank you. Oh, that my words were recorded, that they were written on a scroll, that they were inscribed with an iron tool on lead or engraved in rock forever. I know that my Redeemer lives, and that in the end he will stand on the earth. And after my skin has been destroyed, yet in my flesh I will see God. I myself will see him with my own eyes. I am not another. How my heart yearns within me. This is the word of God.
The Lord bless his word in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I'm going to call Aunt Josephine for the second reading. God bless you as you come.
Second reading is from Revelations 21, 1 to 7. Yes, you can find it from the King James Version. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all things new. And he said unto thee, write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said unto me, it is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son.
Amen. Amen. The Lord blesses the readers in Jesus' name. Amen. We're going to the Word of God. Hallelujah. Amen. Shall we rise up on our feet? As we pray. Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you for this day. We bless you for everything that you have done. We know that your daughter is with you. And we know, as the Father of light, that you will shine the light of your world into every soul here today in Jesus' name. And I pray that as the word of God comes out, it will bless your life in the name of Jesus. I will bring every soul into repentance in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. Have your seat. I want to welcome everyone for honoring our beloved sister. I know that she has touched the life of so many, and that is why we are here today. I know many people could not be here, but they are here with us in spirit. I want to thank God for our priest mother here, hallelujah, for allowing us to use this venue. And I want to bless God for every man of God here and woman of God here that come to honor our sister and the family. And I pray that never again we will come together to bury someone that is very young at the prime of their life again in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. My message to you today, the title is, What is Life to You? My brother, what is life to you? I'm not going to take much of a time, but I just want you to take note of the word that you are going to hear so that when you go back home, you go back and think, have a thought about what you are coming to hear now. By doing so, you are making your way honorable and acceptable to God. Amen. So what is life to you? The Bible has a lot to say about time because our life is about time. The most important thing it taught us is what we already know. What do we know? Our time on earth is limited. Amen.
Amen.
Therefore, time can be used or wasted. It can be invested or squandered. But either way, once used, it can never be regained. So what have you seen your time for? Time matters because we have such a limited supply of it. Don't think you have the whole world, no. Ecclesiastes tells us in chapter 3, verse 1, that to everything there is a season, and a time to every purpose under heaven. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Time matters because we have such a limited supply. How much time do you have? How much time do you have left? Hallelujah. How much time do I have left? Only God knows the answer. You don't know. That is why Psalm 90, verse 12, says, Lord, teach us to number our days that we may gain a heart of wisdom. The question is, have you ever numbered your days? I know it is hard to do, because no one knows how many days they have left. So, this was the reason why James, in his writing, asked the question, what is your life? What is your life? In chapter number 4, verse 14, say, whereas you know not what shall be on the morrow. You don't know what is going to happen tomorrow. But what is your life? It is even a vapor that appears for a little time and then vanished away. My brethren, we need an urgent guidance and help of God if we are to make our life meaningful and productive for God. You need this action. No one has ever lived, listen to this, no one has ever lived for a day on this planet Earth. No one. Do you know why? Not even Methuselah that lived for 969 years. In Genesis chapter 5, verse 27. Do you know? God does not work with our earthly calendar. Okay? According to heavenly calendar, 1,000 years on the planet Earth is just a day in the presence of God. Hallelujah. In the book of Psalm 90, verse 4, if you are writing down, 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 8. Okay. Even our Lord Jesus Christ, based on this calendar, our Lord Jesus Christ just spent 2 days and 22 seconds in the presence of God, according to God's calendar. And we are expecting him to come back now. No. You've got to give your life to God. Give your life to God. 1,000 years on this planet Earth is just one day in the presence of God. So just imagine the longest ever living human being did not complete a day. So we don't have time. Our time is short. Hallelujah. It does not matter how long he lives. Our beloved sister, Akua Abraham, has gone to be with the Lord. She has finished her race. Everybody will go one day. And remember this, you came with nothing and you will return with nothing. According to Hebrews chapter 9, verse 27, he said, it is appointed unto men but to die once. And after this, judgment. Judgment. So why then is life a do or die affair? Why? Why? Why can you not live a peaceful life, be satisfied and enjoy wherever God places you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is what we need. There is more to life than you ever think. We've got to seek for God's mercy and salvation. He is faithful and just to help us navigate through the issues of life. So, brethren, you've got to commit everything to Him. Commit your life to Him. Commit everything to Him. It says, cast your burden on me. Hallelujah. Because why? He's able to do exceedingly abundantly. And he's able to bring your enemies under your feet. A food for thought. Look into your life. If there are many things you are struggling with now, this is the end. But I want to tell us that death does not literally mean end. It's just a beginning of another life. Hallelujah. It's a transport. You see, here we see now because we can no longer relate or see the person again, we thought that is the end. That's not it. It's like you going to London. Can you fly? No. How do you get there? You need something to take you from here to London. Hallelujah. That is just exactly how life, how death is. Amen. We might not see here now, but at the end of the day, in the kingdom of God, we are all going to see ourselves again. That is our hope. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So please, brethren, take account of your life. Take account of your life. Those things that you are fighting about, quarreling about, lusting after, they are just vanity. You don't need them. You don't need them. All these contribute to the stress that we go through. And that is why many cannot live life to the fullest. You've got to let go. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now listen to the word of Psalm 103. I'm rounding up from verse 15 to 18. It said, as for man, his days are like grass. As a flower of the field, so he flourishes. When the wind has passed over it, it is no more. And its place acknowledges it no longer. But the loving kindness of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting on those who fear him, and his righteousness to children's children, to those who keep his covenant and remember his precepts to do them. Hallelujah. In conclusion, what is your life? If you have not trusted Jesus Christ as your Savior, you do not have life. So some of us, we think that when someone is trying to lead us to Christ, or talking to us about God, They have nothing to do with their lives. The question is, does that life belong to you? It doesn't belong to you. You don't have the power. No one has the power to add or to remove from the time you have to spend on this planet Earth. When God knocks today, you are gone. Hallelujah. So, take account of your life. Hallelujah. Amen. John chapter 3 verse 36 says, he who believes in the Son has eternal life, but he who does not obey the Son will not see life. But the wrath of God abides on him forever. So you have the ability to receive the gift of everlasting life if you just accept Christ. He's eager to give you this gift if you trust him as Savior and your Lord. Jesus gave us the promise. In John chapter 10 verse 10, when he said that I came that they may have life and have it abundantly. So brethren, I'm calling on everyone here tonight. If you know that you are not living right, if you know that your life does not glorify God, nobody knows you. You know yourself better than anyone. So, you need to give your life to God. You've got to repent. Many people think that, oh, because I'm a sinner, my sin is so great. Ha. Let me tell you. Who does God love most? The sinner. God doesn't need a righteous person. God loves sinners. He said, heaven rejoices for a sinner that will repent. So, I don't ask you to raise up your hand or to come out, but I want to tell you today, I'm going to pray with you. If you know that you are not living right, if you know that you cannot help yourself, many people think they cannot help themselves. Yes, I believe so. But God is available to help you. Heaven helps those who help themselves. Hallelujah. You just need to take the step of faith and say, today, I'm going to have a change of ways. Because this is the end of the road. All what you have, all what you don't have, one day you will leave them and go. Like I said, you came with nothing and you go with nothing. May God bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. So look into your life. Are you living in that abundant life and free, or you are headed for the wrath of God? The Lord is waiting. The Lord is waiting. If you can take the step of faith and say, Lord, I want to follow you. Lord, I want to accept you as my Lord and my personal Savior. And may God bless you as you take this decision in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 I'm going to pray with you now, so you may close your eyes. Wherever you are, I give you just 1 minute. Just speak to God in your heart. speak to him. He's your father. Talk to him. May God bless this kid in Jesus' name. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I pray for your people. Those that have made that decision now to say, Lord, I want to follow you. Father, I pray for your abundance of grace upon their lives in the name of Jesus. The grace to make changes, oh Lord, let it come upon them now. Father, mighty God, with your tender mercies, receive them, oh Lord. Accept their decision in the name of Jesus. And as you have surrendered your life to them, I pray that nothing will change that mind. You will follow Jesus to the latter, and your name shall be written in the book of life. You will not miss heaven in the name of Jesus. So this decision will bring tremendous changes into your life and your family. And as the trumpet shall sound, you will reign with Christ in his kingdom to come. In Jesus' name. Amen. I call up Pastor John to come and pray for the family.
Shall we all rise, please? The family is good. Come to us. Father, in the name of Jesus, I give you all the praise and glory. From the youngest to the oldest in this family, I commit it to your mighty hand. You are more than able to do exceedingly abundantly, more than that which you have ever asked nor think, according to the power that working through us. Father, I want to thank you for that. I thank you for the mom as well in Ghana. I commit everyone into your mighty hand. In times like this, Father, I pray that you visit them. Minister grace unto their heart and show them your favor and your loving kindness. Holy and everlasting God, we know all a lot has happened, but you are faithful. You are able to do more than that which they are asking now. Father, hold them and uphold them in your mighty hand. Sustain them for everything that they will do. Holy and everlasting God, grant them wisdom, peace, that passeth all man understanding, and do what you alone can do. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. God bless you.
Are you brilliant? May I have your seat? So we are going to read from the number 4. And I call upon that our brother that said, let us be, to come out again.
I have been with you, confessed it.
Please be seated.
Thank you. Thank you. You are all blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Well, I'm going to invite one of our sisters, Ayola, for song ministration. God bless you, Sister Carol.
Goodness is
There's a special request from the Kurasta. He wants to have an organist to play his song, Where is Our God? May God bless you. God bless you.
Words of commendation. Our final words
in this place, in this service, and for so many people to be gathering in this room, I think, for you, that just shows how much your mother, your sister, your friend was loved. As we now pray words over Akua, I ask you, invite you, if you're able, to stand. O God, who gives us life and in whose arms we die, we entrust Akua Abraham to your safekeeping in the faith of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Receive one of your own, one in whom you have been at work, who carries with her our love. Welcome her into your presence, into the resting of everlasting peace, and into the company of all the saints. Loving God, in the mystery of your eternity, we are not separated from Akua, for your love holds us together. While we live, she will not be forgotten among us. In your eternal love, she will never be lost. May our memories of her enrich our lives. May the good things of her life leave a trace on earth. May your keeping of her glorify heaven. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Please sit for prayer. Eternal God, before whose face the generations rise and pass away, we praise you for all your servants departed this life in your faith and love. We give thanks for all your goodness towards Akua, all she accomplished by your grace, and all that she was to those who loved her. And now we praise you that for Akua, sorrow and sickness are ended, death itself is past, and she lives forever in your love and your care, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Allow me to close this part of the service, but I know that you will be travelling to the cemetery together to continue with your final farewells to Akua and her resting in God's peace. It is my turn to say thank you to you for allowing me to share in this part of your lives, to walk with you. It's a privilege in my ministry here. And please know that my prayers will continue to surround you all. I now pray a blessing over you all. May God be a bright flame before you, amen, a guiding star to lighten your darkness. May God smooth the way for you, and when it's hard to see, lead you with his outstretched arm. May God shield you and surround you, hold your sorrows and wipe away your tears. And when you are ready, lift your faces and walk with you into the light of a new day. And the blessing of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you all, and those whom you love, this day and always. Amen. Amen.
So, congregation, please stand and ready to follow outside now. Thank you, gentlemen. I'm going to go to the hospital. sight bended. Clear. Give it a turn of face now, thank you.
Why are you getting that too?
He's decided he's not, or is he coming now?
My mum's
dad. Oh, pardon me, sorry. That's okay. No, that's okay. It's not a problem at all.
Sorry.
proceed. Yeah? So, if you wish to proceed with your prayer, wait for somebody else.
No. He's deciding he's not going to come. Yeah, no. Starry, you mean?
Yes.
Yeah, Starry's not going to be attending this part of the service.
Okay.
All right?
Grace, are you happy for us to proceed?
Yeah? Do you want us to lower first? Yeah? Please do.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Those who have faith in me shall live, even though they die, and no one who lives and has faith in me shall ever die. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that everyone who has faith in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Amen. To God be the glory, we sing as the coffee is flowing.
To God be the glory, great things he has done. So loving the world that he gave us his Son.
That it pleases the Lord to commit our sister to this ground, Akua Abraham. In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Ground to ground, dust to dust.
Thank you.
worthy of our praise. King of glory, we exalt your name. Father, as painful as it is to watch our mom, our aunt, our wife, and our sister, our friend go, we entrust them into your capable hands. And Father, I ask for strength for Enshra, for Elliot, Grace, Prisla, or Chioma, and also James. And I also ask for your strength for Uncle Fifi and the entire family, that your Holy Spirit will strengthen them, that you will heal their pain, O Lord, that there is a day to come when we gather in your glory. Hallelujah. We shall receive the joy everlasting.
Yes.
We pray against division that the enemy would have brought into the family as a result of the departure of our mom, our sister, and our wife, our dear sister, Akua. I thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness. Above all, we leave the family left back home in Ghana into your hands. We pray that you will touch their heart, O Lord. Father, you send your only begotten Son to save the world, that we might not die. So this is not death, but your daughter is resting.
Amen.
For this reason, Lord, we take comfort. We thank you. We bless your name. In the name of God, the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Let's sing "When Peace Like a River."
When peace like a river attended my soul, when sorrows I see billows roll,
that is able to keep us from falling, upon each and every one of us with your right hand of your righteousness, and hold us fast as ever not before. And I say, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
God bless you all. Thank you for coming.
Thank you very much.
It is well. It is well.
It is well. It is well. It is well. It is well. It is well.
I'm happy.
The arrangement is after we finish, few you can stand here for a few minutes, and we have to leave before they cover the grave.
Thank you,
and thank you all very much for coming. Thank you for your support. Thank you.
Neath his wings protecting hide, daily manna still provided. God be with you to me.
And gentlemen, here we've come to the end of the interment of Akua. May his soul rest in peace. We are now heading for the reception hall. So please stay tuned. We may go off and come back again once everything is all settled at the reception, so that you see this live celebration of Akua. God bless you all for the support, the love that you gave to the family. Take care.